As a beginner, you can't skip the phase of exploring how to set up your system. During this process, you'll likely have questions. What are smart lists, regular lists, tags, and filters? Let's break it down and show you how to create them. Smart lists are lists that filter and display tasks based on certain conditions. For example, smart lists like today, tomorrow, and next 7 days will show tasks due today, tomorrow, and in the next 7 days, helping you quickly see what needs to be done during those periods. Assigned to me will display tasks assigned to you from different shared lists, allowing you to view tasks across various shared lists. Additionally, there are three lists: completed, won't do, and trash, which help you quickly see tasks marked as completed, abandoned, or deleted. If you delete a task but want to recover it, you can do so from the trash. For smart lists, we offer three display options: show, hidden, and show if not empty. You can choose whether to show them in your system through the list settings, but you cannot delete them. Between smart lists and regular lists is the inbox. Like smart lists, it cannot be deleted, but you can choose to show or hide it based on your needs. However, in terms of usage, it's more like a regular list. You can use it as a temporary holding place for tasks you don't have time to organize immediately. So what are regular lists? Regular lists are custom lists you create, such as work and personal, to categorize tasks. Of course, categorization isn't limited to work and personal. In last video, we discussed several common list categories, which you can refer to if needed. Welcome is a built-in list. It is designed to help new users learn TickTick. If you don't need it, you can delete it. Now you can add all your ideas and to-dos. Record and remind yourself in regular lists. So we can summarize a simple consensus. The inbox and regular lists mainly serve a storage function where your tasks will be kept. Smart lists, on the other hand, primarily serve a filtering and display function. Tasks stored in the inbox and regular lists will be filtered and displayed in the corresponding smart lists if they meet the criteria. For example, if there are no tasks in the today list, set the due date for buy dog food to today. It will then appear in the today list. Similarly, if I set the due date for meeting with Jack to tomorrow, it will show up in the tomorrow smart list. As your tasks increase, you don't need to check regular lists. Just check the smart list to see the tasks scheduled for today, tomorrow, and the next 7 days. Unlike smart lists, regular lists support multiple editing options. Right-click and select Edit to enter the Edit List page. If you want to make your list categories more intuitive, you can click the hamburger icon in front of the list name to choose an emoji for it. Click and drag the list to rearrange them. Next, let's understand tags and filters. What are tags? Tags are mainly used for secondary categorization, often compensating for the limitations of list categorization. Unlike a task that belongs to only one list, you can add multiple tags to a task to mark its classification. For example, if you have a books list with various books you want to read, you can create tags like fiction, history, printed books, and ebooks to differentiate their detailed categories. You can also set different colors for different tags for better distinction. Just right-click the task to add tags to it. This way, the attributes of each book in the reading list are clearer. Of course, tags have more uses. If you are a corporate salesperson, you have a customer management list. You can add tags like in contact, in progress, and completed to distinguish the status of the cooperation. Alternatively, you can set tags like office, outdoors, and home to quickly check tasks when you reach the corresponding location. Finally, let's understand filters. Filters can multidimensionally screen the tasks you want to view, essentially similar to smart lists, but with greater flexibility. You can freely add and delete filters and choose to set filter conditions like date, tags, and priority to screen the tasks you need. For example, you can add a this week's ebook reading filter, select reading list for the list option, ebook for the tag option, and select this week for the date option. This way, you can quickly confirm the ebooks you plan to read during your waiting or commuting time. These are some basic information on setting up your list system. You can freely build your unique system by choosing the parts you need. Before concluding, I need to mention a small tip. Both regular lists and tags support parent-child relationships. To quickly create them, just drag one onto another, which will help you build a more efficient system.